Good morning. I'm Dr. Karen Griebling, and on behalf of the music department, I'd like to welcome you to this family weekend concert and to invite you to join us afterward for a reception in Trishman Gallery, which is in the building next door across the parking lot. Most of us were too busy warming up our students this morning to get to mingle with you before this event, so we wanted to give you a chance to meet with us afterward. Thank you so much for coming, and thank you for sharing your wonderful sons and daughters with us. You may have been noticing that we have two sets of bows up here, and no, we're not playing with both of them at the same time. One of the advantages to working in a small liberal arts college like this is that we have an opportunity to really and truly connect what we do in our music classes with what we do in our performing ensembles. And one of the things that we're exploring this semester with the Chamber Orchestra is the roots of the classical style of Mozart and Haydn from earlier composers who were in the transitional period between the Baroque period and the later classical period of the 18th century. So in aid of doing that, we're actually using older style bows from the Baroque period, the early 17th and 18th century, which are called Baroque bows. No, they're not, they don't need fixing, sorry. So this next work is actually a piece by Jean-Philippe Rameau, who published one of the first treatises on music theory that had to do with the study of harmony. And we're exploring French music and the evolution of the bow and the evolution of classical style and the evolution of theory, music theory and harmony as we know it in the orchestra this semester. So the next work will give us a chance to hear a very different style of playing than you usually do.
Thank you. to start or talk first. I think I'll talk. Good morning. Thank you all for being here. It's wonderful to have so many families and friends and supporters of music at Hendrix here together today. We'll be singing three pieces for you today. The first one is from Brahms' Requiem, his German Requiem, written when he was but a young guy, my age, in his early 30s, inspired by the death of his teacher, Robert Schumann, very famous composer, and his own mother. And instead of writing a requiem that was in Latin, that was all about praying for the soul of the departed person, he instead wrote one in German using text from the Lutheran Bible, that really spoke to heal the people that were mourning, the people that had felt the loss. And this is just a lovely excerpt from that, and I'll talk a little bit more about our next two after that. Sean Tappan, our composer of our next piece, The Lamb, was a very, very famous British composer who died just a few years ago. This piece, The Lamb, based on poetry by William Blake, is a deceptively complex piece. It's very, very simple in its structure. It relies on three sets of melodies that are first presented by the sopranos, and what you'll hear is that the altos, or at times the basses as well, will come in and they will sing at the exact same time an inversion of the melody. So instead of going up by the same interval, they'll go down by the same interval. And that creates some immense challenges in terms of tuning and intonation with this piece that require a great deal of focus and immense concentration. And then he offsets this with a very, very serene and poignantly beautiful short kind of chorale to cap off each of the two verses of the piece. This is The Lamb by John Tappan. Thank you so much. And we'll close our set with Hark, I Hear the Harps Eternal, an American choral favorite by an old American hymn arranged by Alice Parker, 20th century composer and conductor. She's still kicking it in her 90s. I see her at conferences, and she's still very much a fixture in our professional scene of choral musicians. This is one of her more beloved pieces. And it will feature Francie Wendorf, soprano on solo. Thank you so much.
Hark, I hear the harps eternal.